Moving on though, we have the fission and fusion reactors. Now, what you want to do for these is get a fission controller, which will start with fission first and move to fusion. So you want beryllium, fission casing, a blaze rod, and glass, and the casing is simply made with barium, magnesium, and blaze powder. So obviously with these, you're going to want to use the chemical combiner, for example, after you have barium, which you can get simply from barium chloride, if you're using tech chemistry, or if you're using only alchemistry, you need to use quartz and have a chance of getting that, which is 100%, so it's not too difficult. And once you have the fission multi-block, of course, you can then get certain compounds to be broken down, it seems. So, yeah, because that's obviously the point of the block, is to split things. So, if we just go to that, you can see the template, which is like so, and it says that you need 98 casings, 3 cores, and 1 controller. So, I've already got one built here. If you wanted to, you can use the visualize button, and it'll give you a display if you struggle with multi-blocks. I know that I do, so I definitely welcome this. And we'll just place it here, right-click, and now we can fill in the space accordingly with what we need. So, we'll just place the casings around here. So just go inside the space, and we can see that we just need to fill in the 5x5, I believe it is, space. So there's that, and then we want to, on the outside, fill that in. Because obviously most of this requires casing, the rest is all on the inside. So that is there. Yeah, it can be quite tricky, obviously, after you've filled them in. At least on the inside of the block, not the outside. So, yeah. Now it does show the core here on the inside. Now, from what I was experiencing by testing with this one, I filled it up completely with cores, because that's what I thought I needed to do, but it seems with the actual guide here that you only need 3 on the inside. So, for some reason, I just didn't get that accurately enough. As I have felt like I needed to place like 25 or something, but it seems you don't. So I'll just place 3 on the inside, and that's done. And you can see obviously the progress bar was filling up each time I placed a block, and we have our core here, and now it is completed. So if you're missing anything, it'll say, nope, you don't have it completed yet, and then you can do that. If you don't use the guide from the book, for example, or don't even have the book in general. So, obviously, once it's completed, you then can, obviously, alongside power, have it so that you can convert things like helium to hydrogen, or lithium to helium and hydrogen, and pretty much break down things. So you're splitting what one compound has to the other. A bunch of options there. If we just get a generator, which obviously I happen to remove from my inventory, place this here, give it enough power, and we'll just put in a bunch of random recipes, such as, say, helium, since it's a quick and easy one. And we'll put in one, and we'll see how quick it drains power as well as converts. So we'll go to, say, about 10,000-ish, put that in, and we can see that it almost drains it. So yeah, you're going to want a lot of power, as it is going to use up quite a bit. It doesn't say for each which one it uses, but my guess is it's about the same for each one. We'll just try with something else, like say lithium, as that's going to split two. So that's a 25,000. That's at least not going to do anything. And that will now. Yeah, it seems to be about the same. So it doesn't really matter, as all the actual outcomes will be the same. And otherwise, you can just keep this block here. It's not going to do much else. It's not going to go, oh no, I'm going to drain power if I'm inactive. It's just going to be pretty much a multi-block crafting block that you just happen to give power for it to do things, and otherwise you can just leave it here constantly. So, no problem there. Now, with the fusion one, I'll just build this one as well. Let's see what happens there. So one, which we do have, and obviously find out the recipes. These for casing, we've got that, control of that, and the fission core, which I missed, which is just like so, with chromium and blaze, which if you have a chemical combiner, chromium, other machines, you want emeralds to get that, if you're sticking with alchemistry. But if we go with the fusion, you'll want tungsten, nidium, and enderpearls, along with some selenium, enderpearls in the casing, and then fusion cores, which is thorium. So yeah, many of these you probably need a bunch of other resources like enderpearls, netherwort, and thorium is endstone. So yeah, and it's not as accessible, obviously. So obviously this is a much later game thing. But if we just build, I guess this would be the same as the fusion one, but we'll just see if we can get this for a template. Here we go. This is what we want. We'll visualize that as well. And we'll put it over here. It's most likely going to be exactly the same. And then with the core on the front. And that's, I assume, just supposed to be saying, hey, if you have a power source, or just where the front is, or something like that. So there's that. So we'll just build a 5x5 here as well. And we'll find out what this can do after we finish this. But yeah. Now I don't know if the actual cores inside, when I was placing multiple and testing, happened to make anything more efficient, but my guess is that it's just best to stick with the three in the middle and not place any more than that, as obviously it'd be adding a lot more resources to something that you really don't need to. As I haven't noticed any difference between the other one I built and well, obviously built for this video. So yeah, best to keep things as minimal as possible if you don't want to use up too many resources and still get the same sort of expectation. My guess is this is for breaking things down at a more efficient rate. So, say we'll just put in, I don't know, helium or something. It's not going to do anything. Let's see. What was some of the other stuff I made? Okay, lithium, which you break down like so to get. What exactly? Okay, so lithium gives us helium and hydrogen, so we'll get helium and hydrogen and see if this actually brings it back into that form. So, and it does. Yeah, so you can see how fast that is. Each one, we'll just put in one each, of course. And that's how much it uses. So obviously this is a multi-block to make things more efficient to get resources by combining them. It doesn't show recipes with the actual arrow though, so you'd have to look through here. Yeah, it doesn't seem to also be integrated with JEI either, but it is pretty much the reverse of the fission multi-block. So that one you'll want for breaking down, this one you'll want for combining. So yeah, pretty much similar to some of the other blocks that are single block rather than obviously multi-block, and those are for more efficient ways of doing things. Otherwise, you've got things like the slot filler, which is an A2 refined storage type of thing, which I don't actually currently have on me, but what it says it does is it creates a crafting patterns for the chemical combiner, so you can fill empty slots, which makes sense if you're wanting to lock a recipe and then have it go into the AE or refined storage. So there's that. Otherwise, the slot filler will be ignored by the machine recipe, then consumed with the inputs. So there's that. Otherwise, though, there's a compound list if you want to know exactly what each one does if you happen to consume them, I guess. So you can heal a player, the user can jump and run like a cheetah, they can gain night vision, and have an increase in speed. Same there, and clears all status effects. vision slowness and other things, and then poison. So there's that. Yeah, that seems pretty much it. That's everything, as far as I can tell. There is also, I guess, food spiking as well. Standard food can be spiked with an active compound. When food is consumed, the player will be inflicted with effects. In a hypothetical scenario, yes. I suppose you want to trick your friend. Blah blah blah. So I guess he can do that. You can master the flavor, hide it with such and such by crafting the food with 8 sodium chloride compound items. Okay. So there's that. But finally we have the configs, which allows you to pretty much tweak anything to do with the energy per tick used for a machine, the ticks per operation as well, that each crafting recipe is going to take before it's finished, and then the energy capacity the block has. So for the liquefier, you've got 50, you've got 100, and you've got 100,000, and obviously each one differs slightly in what it can do. And this is just, I assume, for every recipe. It doesn't matter if it's, say, helium or lithium, it doesn't matter. As long as it's just any of these stats, it'll be for every single recipe that this machine is performing. I assume... No, it's only the single ones. Okay, no. Also the fission as well. And fusion. Okay. So the multi-blocks are also included. Thanks so much for watching, though, and goodbye.